Hola, buenas, ¿cómo están? Bienvenidos a un Preguntas y Respuestas a Yandere. Hace un par de días yo a ustedes les pregunté, bueno, en realidad hace varios tiempos yo les pregunté a ustedes si tenían alguna pregunta para Yandere y de a poco fui acumulando, fui haciendo toda una lista de preguntas que me parecieron interesantes para hacerle y hace un par de días se las envié y me las respondió en un video, así que vamos a reaccionar a ese video ahora mismo. Ah, y antes de que me digan, ¿para cuándo el siguiente capítulo de 3 del juego? Ponete animal el 3 del juego. ¿Cuándo vas a hacer el siguiente capítulo de 3 del juego? Victoria, queremos capítulo detrás del juego. Ya sé. Ok, ya sé. Yo estoy animando detrás del juego todos los días. Les juro, les prometo. Así como hacían mis compañeros de clase. No se mueven. Les juro que estoy animando detrás del juego todos los días. No hay un día en el que no animo detrás del juego. Quédense tranquilos. Pero ahora vamos a disfrutar de este video, ¿ok? Ok. Empecemos.
Hello. I haven't uploaded a video in a while because I've been focusing on development, but I've decided to take a quick break to answer some questions that I received from a YouTuber named VictoriaLand5. Let's get started right away. The way that my day begins is probably similar to how your day begins. I take a shower, I eat breakfast, I brush my teeth. And when I'm done with that sort of thing,
dato perturbador. Hay algunas personas que no se cepillan los dientes a la mañana.
To work. First, I check my Discord DMs and emails. That's how I communicate with volunteers who are making assets for the game, fans who need tech support, and companies that I'm discussing business proposals with. A large portion of the day will be spent speaking with 2D artists, 3D modelers, animators, composers, and voice actors. I will also investigate any bug reports that I receive. After all of that has been taken care of, I look at the checklist of remaining work that needs to be done before Yandere Simulator is complete. I select something from that checklist and use the remaining time in the day to work on it. There was a very long period of time where, every day at 7 p.m., I would stop working to play video games for 3 hours and then return to work afterwards. However, over the past few months, I haven't done that very much at all. I'm not sure when or if I'll ever return to that schedule. On some days,
yo sé que a nadie le importa, pero yo hago bastante parecido. O sea, literalmente me levanto y lo primero que hago es ponerme a revisar a ver si alguien me manda un mensaje. Después me fijo en la lista de cosas que tengo que hacer para atrás del juego, tipo. Tipo las voces que me faltan, los modelos que me faltan, los escenarios, qué sé yo. Tipo, a veces me hago una lista de diciendo, bueno, para mañana tengo que tener terminada la escena 15 del capítulo. Entonces es como que me pongo eso para hacer y bueno, nada, ya sé que a nadie le importa, pero bueno, nada, quería aportar algo en el video.
I receive so many assets from volunteers that the entire day is spent putting those assets into the game, testing them, reviewing them, and requesting revisions. On other days, I receive a large number of bug reports, and almost the entire day is spent fixing bugs. And then, on other days, I receive almost no new assets or bug reports, so I get to spend the majority of the day just working on new features. In short, I would say that the work I do on any given day is determined as the day goes by, rather than being determined by a plan that I had at the beginning of the day.
¿Existirían los male rivals? Ojo, ojo, ojo. Esta pregunta me la hicieron, o sea, me pidieron que se la hiciera a Yandrev 80.000 veces. O sea, 80.000 veces me pidieron que hiciera esta pregunta a Yandrev. De paso, aprovecho a mostrarles a mi budito. ¡Ay, es un amor! ¡Lo que es un Bueno, perdón, sigamos.
The second most popular video on my entire YouTube channel is the male rival introduction video, a video that I made as an April Fool's Day prank. It actually has more views than the female rival introduction video.
El video de los hombres
fans regularly comment on that video and express their desire for the male rivals to become real. However, it seems that nobody actually wants to eliminate the male rivals. Instead, it seems that players want to be romanced by the rivals. That isn't really the type of gameplay that I was planning to provide with Yandere Simulator. So if that's what people are asking for when they want the male rivals, I don't think that's gonna happen. After all of the female rivals are finished, I might be willing to consider the idea of allowing the player to toggle the genders of the rivals from male to female, but it would require a lot of money, since I would have to pay animators and voice actors to make male versions of all the rivals' animations and voiced lines. So, it's something that could only happen if the crowdfunding campaign is a massive success and raises an extra large amount of money. If another developer is interested in the idea of developing a visual novel about the male rivals trying to romance the player, I would be willing to consider collaborating with them to make it happen. However, I don't have any plans to make that type of game myself.
Es que ese es el problema. O sea, el problema es de los rivales masculinos es que nadie quiere matarlos. O sea, literalmente lo que dice Yandrev, nadie quiere matarlos. Todos quieren romantizar, digamos, que sean novios de Ayano, cuando en realidad el juego se trata de matar. Y ese es el problema por el cual él... Yo creo que es el mayor problema por el cual él no quiere meterlos. Porque si fuera el hecho de solamente cambiarles el sexo, tipo que... No me sé bien los nombres, creo que Azurrito sea Aso, Aso puede ser. Sé que son los nombres de ellas, solamente que le agregan una O o algo así para que parezca hombre. Pero, o sea, si fuera simplemente cambiarles el sexo y que allá no pudiera matarlos, yo creo que él lo haría. Pero el problema es que todos quieren que los rivales tengan un romance con Ayano y eso ya sería bastante complicado porque tendrían que literalmente hacer un juego nuevo. Pero bueno, dice que si alguien propone la idea de hacer una visual novel, él estaría dispuesto a colaborar. Así que si alguien quiere hacer una visual novel, un jueguito de esos de tener novios, ¿cómo se llama? No sé, yo creo que lo máximo que llegué a jugar era el de, ¿cómo se llama este juego? Corazón de Melón. Pero si alguien llega a hacer ese tipo de juegos con los rivales masculinos, él estaría dispuesto a colaborar, así que... Pero definitivamente Yandere Simulator es algo muy complicado.
There is a lot of information that I have not revealed about Ryoba and Jokichi's relationship. You know that Ryoba kidnaps him and holds him prisoner in her basement in 1989. You know that they eventually get married. And you know that they have a child together in the mid-2000s. But there are huge gaps of time where it's not exactly clear what they were doing. Did Ryoba turn Jokichi into a mind-broken slave? Did he only enter a relationship with her because he was afraid that she would kill him if he didn't? Did he develop Stockholm Syndrome and gradually fall in love with her? Or did something entirely different transpire? Of course, I have all the answers, and everything will be revealed in the basement tapes. These are cassette tapes that the player can obtain by moving furniture in Ayano's basement. Ayano only moves furniture when she is making room for her kidnapped victims. So, the only way to collect all of the basement tapes and learn the truth about Ryoba and Jokichi will be to kidnap 10 girls, thus uncovering the 10 tapes. There are currently only 2 basement tapes in the game. The next time I add a basement tape will be after I have finished implementing Amai, which will happen after the game's crowdfunding campaign, which will happen after I have finished going down the checklist of everything I want to add, change, fix, or improve about the game. I currently don't have an estimate for when any of those things will happen, but you can always visit my development blog to see the latest progress on the checklist.
Como es, yo al principio pensaba que Jokichi, digamos, tenía una relación parecida a la detrás del juego, como que no la quiere a Ryoba y simplemente está con ella porque, a ver, no le queda, no tiene muchas más opciones. Pero después con el corto que salió hace poco en el que Ryoba lo tenía encerrado y la empresa Saiko lo secuestró a Jokichi y todo eso, yo entendí por lo que decía Ryoba como que Ryoba estaba intentando de alguna forma enamorarlo a Jokichi. Entonces dije, ok, a lo mejor no es que no esté enamorado de Ryoba, o bueno, más o menos, pero sino que tiene el síndrome de Estocolmo, que digamos... se enamoró de ella, de su secuestradora. Yo pensé eso. Pero ahora con lo que está diciendo él, realmente no sé. Porque dice, puede ser esto, puede ser lo otro. O quién sabe. Entonces es como, bueno, no sé, entonces no sé nada. Va a haber que esperar a ver.
Canonically, Ryoba eliminated her 10th rival, Sonoko, by doing a massive favor for her and becoming friends with her. Afterwards, Sonoko defended Ryoba during her murder trial by testifying that Ryoba was a good person who would never commit a crime. She did this despite the fact that her mentor, the journalist, had accused Ryoba of murder. Sonoko was willing to betray her own mentor to defend Ryoba, but it's not because she was friends with Ryoba. Sonoko only did this out of fear. After everything that Ryoba did in order to earn Sonoko's trust, Sonoko realized that Ryoba was not an ordinary woman. She possessed a wide range of extraordinary skills. She was afraid of absolutely nothing, and she would do anything to achieve her goals, no matter the cost. After learning just how dangerous Ryoba was, Sonoko became completely convinced that Ryoba was the serial killer responsible for the recent murders at Akademi. However, she had no desire to expose Ryoba. Instead, she wanted to get on Ryoba's good side. Sonoko defended Ryoba in court because she was terrified that Ryoba would retaliate against her if she didn't. After the trial ended, Sonoko kept her distance from Ryoba and never interacted with her or the journalist ever again.
Ojo, que yo terminé de jugar al modo 1980 y me quedo de que ellas fueron amigas. Pero no, parece que no. Parece que literalmente, o sea, ella, Sonoko, se dio cuenta de que Ryoba era la asesina y decidió mentir ante la corte para que Ryoba no, digamos, no meterse en problemas con Ryoba. No sé, yo terminé el juego y terminé entendiendo que eran amigas, pero bueno, recién ahora me estoy enterando que no y que Sonoko descubrió que Ryoba era asesina, no sé. Yo, a mí me sorprendió mucho esta respuesta. Yo pensé que realmente fueron amigas y que realmente la defendió por ser amiga, pero parece que no.
Ayano is not aware of the fact that her mother kidnapped her father in 1989. But even if she did know, it probably wouldn't change her opinion of either parent very much. She knows that her mother possesses an extraordinary amount of knowledge about getting away with crimes. And she knows that her father is meek towards her mother. So learning that their relationship began with a kidnapping really wouldn't come as much of a surprise to her. My favorite male character is Saisho Saiko, the grandfather of Megami Saiko. I've written a very long and elaborate backstory for him that spans multiple decades. Some of his backstory is communicated through the headmaster tapes, although many of the details are sprinkled in other places, like some of the profiles on the characters page of the official website. Actually, Saisho Saiko is directly responsible for... On second thought, I shouldn't say anything about.
Ok, teoría. Tengo una teoría. Yo desde hace mucho tiempo, pero mucho tiempo, tengo la teoría de que los Aishi son estilo Ackerman. Tengo esa teoría. Y para mí, a ver, si se fijaron al final del juego de 1980, sale todo como una línea de tiempo del pasado en el que menciona la Segunda Guerra Mundial. Y tengo la teoría de que ahí pasó algo que, no sé, quisieron crear armas o algo. Y experimentaron con ciertas personas y por eso es que la familia Aishi desarrolló tanta fuerza, poder y digamos, son armas de guerra, digamos, y la familia Saiko tiene algo que ver con eso porque ellos intentaron desarrollar armas. Bueno, no sé, tengo esa teoría y no sé, siento que es eso o va por ahí, a lo mejor va por ahí. Pero tengo la teoría que son estilo Ackerman.
Spoil the surprise. If you want to learn just how much influence Saisho has had over the events of Yandere Simulator, you'll just have to wait until the game is finished. A lot of joke games and meme games have the word simulator in the title. As a result, a lot of people identify Yandere Simulator as a joke game. On January 13th, 2016, I suggested the idea of renaming Yandere Simulator to something that would be easier to take seriously. I suggested the name Lovesick, and I even asked a graphic designer to create a logo for me. A lot of time has passed since then. I still wish that I had picked a better name than Yandere Simulator, and I still think that Lovesick is a cool name. But I think that it might be a bad idea to try to rename the game at this point in time. And I think I can explain why with two words. Brand recognition. Right now, millions of people know what Yandere Simulator is. When they want to see the latest news and updates, they do a search for Yandere Simulator. If I change the name to Lovesick, and a lot of people aren't aware that the game's name is changed, they'll keep searching for Yandere Simulator, but they won't see the latest news and updates anymore. They'll think that the game just stopped updating. What if I rename the game, and then I finish it, and then I release it, but nobody notices, because everyone was Googling Yandere Simulator instead of Lovesick? That would be horrible. I could potentially fix this problem by naming the game Lovesick, a Yandere Simulator, so that when people search for Yandere Simulator, they still get the game they're looking for. But this feels like a weird workaround that completely defeats the purpose of renaming the game in the first place. When I think of all the potential reasons that renaming the game could backfire, I feel like it would be smarter to just keep the name as it currently is. I might change my mind about this in the future, but for now, my plan is to just keep calling the project Yandere Simulator right up until its release.
Sí, para mí tiene lógica. Ojo, esta pregunta a mí me interesa, pero me parece que no la respondió como yo quería. Va, como yo quería, o sea, me dejó con más dudas. Porque yo le pregunté esto con la idea de que me respondiera qué onda con la enfermera y la profesora. O sea, ¿cómo es eso? ¿Va? Supongo que Senpai va a ser el que se los va a confesar a ellas, no sé, ni idea. O ellas a él, no sé, pero que le van a dejar una notita, que la enfermera o la profesora va a ir y le va a dejar una notita en el casillero de Taro, y Taro va a tener que ir al árbol de cerezos y va a estar ahí la profesora con todo el uniforme de profesora esperándolo en el árbol de cerezo y él con el uniforme y se van a confesar ahí los sentimientos. O sea, ¿cómo es eso? Pero bueno, no sé, no, me gustaría saber cómo va a ser eso.
The cherry tree behind the school has been a big part of the game's visual identity for a long time, and it also holds an important place in the game's lore. For these reasons, I'm planning for all of the game's rivals to confess their feelings to Senpai underneath that cherry tree. I really wouldn't be willing to consider making the rivals confess their love anywhere else. Between Ayano and Ryoba, I think that my favorite character would be Ryoba. Because of the lengthy and detailed life story that I've written for her. Small bits and pieces of her story can be found in the game's cassette tapes. But the most interesting facts about Ryoba will only be divulged at the end of Yandere Simulator, if the player meets the criteria to unlock the true ending. I don't really think it would be appropriate for me to start planning downloadable content before the game's main story mode is complete. I think I should focus all of my attention on completing the base game before I start planning any additional content. However, with that said, sometimes, just for fun, it can be interesting to imagine what types of DLC Yandere Simulator might get one day. I've come up with ideas for DLC rivals that could be released after the main story mode is complete, but I'm not ready to reveal them or talk about them at this point in time. I might eventually make a video about them on my main channel, but I won't make any promises just yet. You'll just have to wait and see. It can be fun to imagine what the Yakuza might look like in modern day, or think about what he's been doing for the past 30 years, or consider what kind of services he might provide to Ayano. However, at this point in the game's development, I really don't want to plan any new features for the game that would take a significant amount of time to implement, so I doubt that the Yakuza will return, or even be mentioned at all, in Ayano's story mode. One thing that we almost never see in Yandere Simulator is...
Pausa. Yo acá tengo un grave problema con esta pregunta. Resulta que yo cuando estoy escribiendo detrás del juego, muchas veces me pregunto, y Tresor también me pregunta, Tresor es la chica que hace la voz de InfoChan y ella me ayuda muchísimo con los guiones, ¿qué pasa con los padres de los estudiantes con las muertes que están habiendo en el colegio? ¿Por qué no se quejan? ¿Por qué no hacen movimiento? ¿Por qué no se movilizan? Y no solamente los padres, o sea, los mismos estudiantes, o sea, vos ves que está muriendo gente, ¿por qué no te vas del colegio? No sé, es raro, los padres no ven que, o sea, por más de que no se le muera a su propio hijo, si ven que están muriendo chicos o desapareciendo chicos en ese colegio, yo como padre diría, che, no sé, como que se me antoja cambiar de colegio mi hijo. No sé, pero bueno, yo quería saber eso.
How the parents of the students react to their children dying or disappearing. Honestly, I don't like to think about it because it's very sad to imagine. I suppose that when a student dies or goes missing, the headmaster feels guilty about it. He asks himself if he should have implemented stricter safety measures or security measures at school. Feeling partially responsible for the dead or missing student, he might even personally apologize to the parents of the student. There is also a possibility that PsychoCorp could bribe the parents to stay quiet about their dead or missing children to avoid harming the school's reputation. Aside from that, I haven't really put much thought into it, and I don't really know what else to say about the situation.
Pero ¿cuánta plata le tiene que ofrecer lo de la organización esta Psycho para un padre que perdió un hijo? Para que no diga nada. O sea, hay que ser un padre bastante hijo de... Porque allá no trae el apellido de su madre. Ah, esto también.
In most cultures, a woman will acquire her husband's last name when she gets married. So, why has the Aishi name persisted for so long? I'll explain. It can be beneficial for a man to take his wife's last name if his wife belongs to a famous or prestigious family. And in the 1800s, the Aishi name was actually quite well known because it was associated with something. High quality textiles. Beginning in the 18th century, Japanese farm women, during seasonal cold periods in northern Japan, used a home loom to weave scraps of old fabrics into sakiori textiles, producing everything from rugs to clothing. Around the beginning of the 1800s, the women of the Aishi family became quite proficient at weaving these fabrics and made a living from it. In fact, they produced such impressive textiles that, for a time, the name Aishi was associated with quality fabrics and clothing. They were so famous for their work that marrying into the Aishi family was considered prestigious. Thus, the Aishi name persisted
Aichi.
Into modern
Lo traduje
day.
Mal, perdón.
As the decades passed, the family continued to pass down their knowledge of sewing and weaving fabrics. That is the reason why Ryoba and Ayano can instantly craft almost any type of garment they need, as long as they have the necessary fabric. Scarves, swimsuits, and even harnesses worn under the clothing for carrying weapons discreetly.
Si ya no carecen... Ah, oh, esto lo pregunté más que nada por la serie. Nada, es que también me interesa
Under
mucho
the
la historia
clothing.
de... Entre Ayano y Hokichi. Si Ayano carece de emociones, entonces ¿por qué ella quiere ver a su padre feliz? Pasa que en otro Preguntas y Respuestas dijo que ella fingía para que él sea
Ayano
feliz.
is not emotionless. She does have feelings. However, she perpetually experiences a sensation of being hollow and empty. It's a sensation that persists every hour of every day. You can satisfy hunger by eating. You can satisfy thirst by drinking. You can warm yourself up when you're cold, and you can turn on a light when you're in the dark. But there is nothing that an Aishi can do to alleviate the feeling of being hollow and empty. It's a feeling that will persist for their entire life until they are in the proximity of their soulmate. Only then will the hollow feeling go away and allow them to experience life like a normal person, without suffering from a perpetual sensation of emptiness.
¿Sabes que me lo imagino como como el beso del verdadero amor? Ese estilo me lo imagino. Que romperá el hechizo o algo así.
Condition will feel hollow and numb, but they can still feel emotions. Ayano can feel gratitude towards her parents for raising her. She can feel bad for her father when she notices that he is sad. And she can feel a desire to make him smile. This is why Ayano pretends to be a normal girl around her father. Even though she can't escape the Aishi condition, she still tries to be a good daughter to her parents.
Aprenderemos más información acerca de los demás familias de Aishi.
I've written out a lengthy history for the Aishi family, beginning in 1797 and ending in modern day. For a long time, I've wanted to make a video covering the Aishi family's entire history. I've even prepared artwork so that I can show you what various members of the Aishi family looked like. However, I've decided to stop making videos to focus my time and attention on game development. So I'm not actually sure when that video will get made.
Me pregunto si habrá alguna Aishi que jamás encontró a su senpai. Hubiese sentido ese vacío durante toda su vida. Me pregunto qué habrá pasado con él.
I'm not ready to reveal the names of the Aishi family members who came before Ryoba, but I'll share one piece of information with you. Every child in the Aishi family is named after a type of blade, whether it's a knife, a saw, a sword, or any other object used for cutting. For example, Ryoba is actually the word for a type of Japanese saw blade. There was a Tsurugi Aishi, a Takagi Aishi, and so on. I hope you'll look forward to learning all about them.
Conclusión.
As always, I had a lot of fun answering the questions that Victoria Land 5 prepared for me. It was nice to take a little break from my usual routine, but now it's time for me to get back to work on the game. Remember, you can always visit my blog to learn the latest news about the game's development, and you can join my Patreon to see previews of upcoming content before anyone else.
Una vez yo quería unirme, va, lo pensé, tipo, hacer eso lo de la donación de PayPal, porque parece que si no donas no sé cuánto, aparece tu logo en el juego, en el Yandere Simulator, pero dada la situación económica en mi país, dije, no, bueno, mejor otro día.
That's
más adelante.
All I have to say for now. Thank you for following the development of Yandere Simulator.
Está bien bonito. Y bueno, eso ha sido todo por hoy. Espero que les haya gustado el preguntas y respuestas a Yandere Dev. Yo creo que va a pasar un tiempo bastante largo hasta que le vuelva a hacer preguntas, porque creo que ya le preguntamos todo. No sé, yo no sé, a lo mejor ahora empiezo a armar otra lista. Si quieren hacerle alguna otra pregunta, pueden dejarla en los comentarios, pueden hacérmelo por dejarme las preguntas por Instagram, por Discord, por donde quieran. Yo siempre voy a tener una listita ahí para preguntarle a Yandere Dev, así que cualquier duda que tengan con él, lo agrego a la lista, para en un futuro volver a hacerle un preguntas y respuestas. Ahora mismo me voy a poner a animar detrás del juego, y quería recordarles que tengo un canal secundario que se llama Victoria Grayson, que de hecho... Mirá lo que es esto. ¡Ay, qué bonito! Victoria Grayson. Y bueno, nada, eso. Y que ahora mismo no voy a estar subiendo muchos videos acá porque, como les dije, estoy animando detrás del juego. Antes sí, digamos, estaba... Me puse a jugar con Julio, el chico que le hace la voz a Taro. Me puse a jugar con Julio el juego... No sé dónde ponerlo. Bueno, me lo dejo acá. Me puse a jugar con Julio el modo de 1980. Pero ahora mismo necesito tiempo para animar detrás del juego, así que va a estar un poco abandonado ese canal ahora, pero ni bien termine de animar detrás del juego, voy a volver a subir videos, no sé si jugando, jugando juegos o no sé, ya veré, con el tiempo veremos. Así que bueno, nada, espero que les haya gustado el video y chao.